Welcome to One Chemistry. Always do your best. Now, let us see about top 20 problems in SN1 and SN2 reaction. These are all the very basic reaction everybody should know fully. Stay tuned for complete information. What is inside this video? We will see what is SN1 and SN2, then we will see some basics, then we will see how we can find SN1 or SN2 types, then we can see about the controlling parameters such as stearic effect, unstability and chemoselectivity and neighboring group participation. We will see one by one. At first, let us understand what is SN1 and SN2. Let us understand from football. If one guy makes the goal, it is like SN1 reaction, which is one molecule makes the product. Similarly, if two guys are making goals, SN2 reaction, which is two molecules give the product. It's all about the participation of the molecule in the rate determining step. So SN1 and SN2, you should know in simple terms. SN1 reaction is two-step reaction where alkyl bromide converted into cation, then the OH- attacks to form alcohol. Here SN1 reaction because the cation formation involves only one, which is slow step involving only one molecule. It is slow because the neutral molecule converted into charged cation. Here important thing you should know is the cation is planar. Top and bottom attack is possible, so the product is always racemic mixture. Similarly, we can understand SN2 reaction. What is SN2 reaction mean? Nucleophile attacks from the back side of the substrate, forms slow transition state, then it converts into alcohol. The step is slow because carbon is attaining impossible 5 valency. The important thing you should know here is the attack is backside and the product is always immersion in configuration, which is R2S, S2R. Here I summarize what is SN1 and SN2. Here both cases two molecules are involved, but rate determining step only one molecule involved in SN1, two molecules involved in SN2. The number of steps in SN1 is 2. SN2 is 1. Why 1 mean? It's a concerted, means it's like cyclic kind of mechanism. Favorable carbocation is for SN1, it is tertiary. For SN2, it's primary. The favorable structure for SN1 is planar. For SN2, it's a non-planar system. For solvent, SN1, it is polar is favorable because it's the cation formation, polar solvent stabilize it. For SN2, the non-polar solvent which cannot stabilize it. SN2, it's non-polar solvent. The product configuration SN1 is racemic mixture. SN2, it's inversion in configuration. But important thing you should know is secondary carbon can undergo both SN1 and SN2. Let us understand the SN1 and SN2 through question. The question number 1 is rigidity versus SN1. Here we are given 3 different alkyl halides. How the reaction influenced by the structure of the molecule. The first one is like tertiary bromide, which is A. B is like bridged bromide. C is also bridged bromide, but only one bridged carbon. So here we very well know that bridged carbon strain is very high, so impossible to form planar carbocation. But we have to compare relatively. A, there is no problem, straight away forms the cation. So it is always A is the highest rate. And B is the second highest because the bridged carbon forms stable 6-member ring. So it's always stable, less strain, can be planar sometime. So it's the second one. Third one is like bridged bromide, which cannot form cation because the structure is very rigid, 5-member system. So if you compare the rate, A is higher, B is second, and C is the least one. So normally you should know is less strained the compound, easy will be the formation of cation. Question number 2, which is SN1 reaction is possible in the structure but not racemization, why? We very well know that the SN1 always backside and front side attack is possible. So, but here the hydrogen atom sterically hindered the backside. So the backside attack here is not possible, only front side. Even though it's SN1 reaction, only one is possible. That's why the product is not resonating mixture. It's a very important question. This question you can answer only if you understand the steric effect in the reaction. Let us see the question number 3, same rigidity versus SN1. Here I given the compound A and B. A is the carbon atom connected to 3 phenyl ring. The second structure is a fan kind of structure where bridged carbon and phenyl system. It is kind of fan like 3D structure. We very well know that carbocation needs the planarity. But here you can see the compound is bridged structure is very rigid in B. So B cannot form carbocation, A can form carbocation and stabilize itself. So here you have to answer in terms of rigidity. So SN1 reaction A is faster than B. So you should know that lesser strain in the compound, more easy the formation of cation. Then the next one is, why this SN1 reaction possible in the bridged carbon here? Because we already know bridged carbon never the reaction is possible. But in some forced cases SN1 reaction is possible. Here I given the compound which kind of chlorinated ester kind of structure. Here the reaction is possible since you are using the very strong catalyst which is AgCl and the very good leaving group CO2. If you forcefully push out of CO2 and AgCl, you get the better intermediate cation. That cation can attack the phenyl ring, you form the product. This is a very tricky one, but definitely this is possible in terms of extreme conditions. Then the next one is unstable molecule and SN1 reactivity. Here two molecules are given, which is A and B. A and B differ only in terms of bridged cyclopropyl system. So in every bridge you have cyclopropyl system. You should very well know that the cyclopropyl has special kind of stability because of its overlapping p orbital. So the compound which has the more propyl system can be stabilized by the perpendicular p orbitals. So the cyclopropyl system substituted ring is very stable. So if you compare A and B, B will be very faster reaction because of its cyclopropyl architecture. Next thing will be neighboring group participation. What is neighboring group participation mean? It's like neighboring group participation mean the electron rich species can help the leaving group to leave better. Here I given that OTS, which is leaving group, where the oxygen is the electron rich species. Oxygen can be nearby or far away or in the sixth position. Here it's differed from the fact that the neighboring group is trans to the leaving group is better. So the oxygen trans to the OTS mean it can be better. If you compare A, B, C and D, D will be faster because it's trans to OTS group and C will be better because the ring strain in the OTS attack is possible because the ring strain in O2 OTS is less, but B it's a cyclopropyl very trans thing, so it is very least and A is very very least. So oxygen is the neighboring group, it helped to kick out the leaving group. The same neighboring group participation is here, but here the neighboring group is like double bond. Normally the electron rich species is the neighboring group participation. We are comparing A, B, C and D. A is obviously least because there is no much contribution in the double bond, but B, C and D, D is very much higher, we can easily know because two double bonds are there. The real question comes between B and C. So we already know that the neighboring group transposition is very favorable. So when compared to B and C, C will be faster, B is the next one. So you should know transposition is better for the neighboring group. The next kind of question will be, why the substitution is B is faster than A? Here A and B differ in terms of OTS. In the A, OTS in the endo means inside. B, OTS is exo, which is outside. But to participate the neighboring group, there should be sufficient position in the backside and the leaving group should be trans. So if you take A and B, B will be the better position to kick out OTS. So B is faster reaction than OTS. So neighboring group increases the rate when it is in trans position. Here Here it is a tricky question, which one will go faster between A and B? So here you can see A and B, phenyl ring is assisting as well as the double bond is assisting. So which can go? But here you should know the stability concept. If you take the electron from benzene, you are disturbing the ring current, disturbing the stability. So the groove opposite double bond is very much stable, which can undergo faster. Here the argument in terms of stability, not in terms of pi electrons. So you should know, you should not disturb the aromaticity in the neighboring group participation. Next and very common one is the ring expansion reaction is SN1. Normally this kind of question will be asked in the competitive examination. So here the alkyl halide reacts with OH, form A and B. So you should know which is the major product here. A and B are possible, you should know which is higher. According to the theory, B is higher because the stability of carbocation dictates whether ring expand or contract. Let us see step by step. The first step is formation of carbocation. You remove the Br and cation forms. Then you know that the secondary cation is very much unstable when compared to tertiary cation. Here you know that carbocation forms, but ring strain is so much higher. Moreover, the carbocation also can be stabilized by the expansion of the ring. Hence, the strain relieved from the expansion of ring, the stable cation forms. That's why you get the product always B. So the theory is the ring strain as well as tertiary cation is more stable than primary cation. The next question will be on ring contraction. If there is a ring expansion is possible, in some cases ring contraction also possible. Here I given the reaction, which is the alkyl halide. There is a two kind of possibility, which is straightforward OH attachment as well as a rearranged ring contracted product. Here B is the major product because of the stability of the cation. Let us write the step by step reaction. So first step is formation of cation. So everybody know cation formation is there. We very well know that the secondary cation is very least stable than tertiary cation. So ring contracts and form the tertiary cations. So the tertiary cation forms, if you write the equivalent, it will be like 6 member ring outside the isopropyl kind of architecture. Where OH attacks, we get the product B. So the B is the major product in the reaction. So you should know ring contraction also possible. Here it is a very important one, ring contraction, even though it's a strain molecule. Here the two type of possibility, A and B. Why it is happening? B also possible. B is the major product. Let us see why. We very well know that cyclopropyl system has extra stability because of its p orbital architecture. So let us see, system promotes cyclopropyl system. First step is the removal of chlorine. We form the cation. Second step is like breaking up that particular bond. Rearrangement to form stable carbocation architecture containing cyclopropyl system. So if you rewrite it, you have 3 member ring with cation outside. The OH attacks, so it's formed. The reaction is very much important because extra stability of the carbonyl group is driving the reaction to happen. Even though it's a ring contraction to the strain system, the super stability justifies it. The next one is chemoselectivity in SN2 reaction. Let us consider a molecule with 2 bromine where the SN2 reaction will happen. We very well know that there is a 2 possibility, A and B. Both bromine can be replaced by OH. But what is possible? We very well know that SN2 is happen through backside attack. So there should be a space for backside attack. When compared to the bromine in the ring position as well as free bromine is favorable because of its less crowded architecture. So you should know, less crowded promote the reactions. The next one is like steric assistance. What is steric assistance? Let us compare the SN1 reaction rate between A and B. A and B only differ the iodine in axial position, iodine in equatorial position. Here A is favorable because the steric repulsion between tertiary butyl group and iodine is very high. So tertiary butyl group create the strain and remove the iodine. So here the steric assistance to the reaction. So A is faster than B. B, there is nothing there because iodine is equatorial, the strain is relieved. There is no steric assistance. So A is higher rate than B. Next one is finding the product by exchanging the solvent. The reaction between A and B, only the solvent is different, which is KOH and water. What is favorable? We very well know that strong base favors SN2 reaction, where Cl is replaced by its tightly OH, which is SN2 reaction. Similarly, the weak base water, normally it happens through SN1 reaction. There is a chance for SN1 reaction because the intermediate cation stabilized by resonance also. So you should have the call that which will go through SN1 or SN2 based on the base stability of cation. So you should know that one. Next is the chemoselectivity in substitution. Here the starting metal contains bromine and iodine. The nucleophile is NaCN. There is a two kind of product is possible. CN can replace iodine. CN can replace bromine. So which is possible? Here you should know which is the better leaving group can decide the reaction. So iodine is the better leaving group because of its basicity. So iodine can replace by CN. Here the reaction decided by leaving group, not from reactant, not from nucleophile. Next question is very basic one. It is about inversion in configuration. Normally the questions will be asked from R configuration. They will ask you to judge the product. If you start from R configuration, the attack from SN2 is on backside. So you should know S configuration will come. If you start from S, the R will come. So you should know inversion in configuration. Very particularly, you should know the bottom one, which is the cyclopropyl system. You should always predict attack from backside. If the leaving group in axial position, you get the product in equatorial position. So you should always judge from the backside attack, which is on inversion configuration. Then the very common question, which one will go faster, SN1? Here the substrate which contains the more substituted methyl group. Here we know that carbocation is formed in SN1. So the intermediate which stabilized by the methyl group will form more. So D has more methyl group, hence hyperconjugation is more or plus I effect is more. So D is better because 3 methyl group. C comes next one, which is 2, B is 1, A has nothing. So you should know plus I effect stabilizes the cation, hence more methyl group, faster will be the SN1 reaction. Next one is which one will go SN1 faster. Here I given the question, which is alkyl bromide, then alkenyl bromide, then dienyl bromide, then bromobenzene. Here you can quickly commit the mistake, D is faster, but D is not faster because you have to break the bromine bond. The double bond in bromine is very strong, so D will come very least. Then you can guess the after leaving a bromine you have the cation. So the more cation stabilizing species you get the higher one. So C has the 2 double bond in conjugation, so the more stability. B has the next one, which is only 1 double bond. A has nothing, so which is come after D. So D is the least one, C is the better one. So it's all about the stability of cation and removal of bromine group. The last one is about the SN1 reaction rate, which one will go faster. Here SN1, if they directly ask me, you have to write the counter ion, which is cation directly, which is intermediate. So you write the intermediate. So you should judge which intermediate is stable. So we very well know that the resonance stabilizes much better than plus I effect. So the benzyl cation stabilizes much better by benzene ring. Then the cation stabilizes by 2 methyl ring because of its plus I effect. Then the least will be ethyl cation. So should know SN1 intermediate is cation. Stability of cation decides the reactivity here. That's all from me today. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below.